Let's take a look at statistical significance versus practical significance in hypothesis testing. Hypothesis testing tests for statistical significance. Statistical significance means the effect observed in the sample was unlikely to have occurred due to chance alone. Or in other words, it would be very unlikely to see what was observed in the sample if the null hypothesis is in fact true. Whether that effect has any practical importance is an entirely different question. Suppose a call center claims their average wait time is 30 seconds. We decide to test the null hypothesis that the population mean is 30 against the alternative hypothesis that the mean is greater than 30. We go ahead, get a sample, find a sample mean of 30.6 seconds, and carry out a test and get a resulting p-value of 0.002. A p-value of that size gives very, very strong evidence against the null hypothesis, and very strong evidence in this case that the population mean is actually greater than 30 seconds. But in the sample, we observe this sample mean to be 30.6 seconds, a difference of only 0.6 seconds from the null hypothesis. I think in this situation, most people would feel that that difference of 0.6 seconds doesn't really have any practical meaning. But perhaps the company feels differently. Perhaps the company wants to make sure the wait time is no more than 30 seconds on average, and so they feel that that 0.6 seconds is an important difference. We simply don't know. What we can say in statistics is that this p-value is very small, giving strong evidence against the null hypothesis. And we'll leave it up to others to decide if that has practical importance. How could there be such strong evidence against the null hypothesis if the difference from the hypothesized value is so small? Well, statistical significance is strongly related to sample size. If the sample size is large enough, even tiny differences from the hypothesized value will be found statistically significant. On the flip side of things, if the sample size is small, then it can be difficult to find a statistically significant difference. To illustrate, suppose we're testing the null hypothesis that mu is equal to 10 in 6 different situations. I've set the variance to be exactly equal in the 6 different spots to level the playing field. In this first set of box plots, the sample size is 10 for each of the 3 samples. I've plotted in the hypothesized value of 10 here with a red line. The first sample had a sample mean of 10.05, the second one had a sample mean of 10.1, and the third one had a sample mean of 10.2. The p-value of the test is very large in all 3 spots, indicating no evidence against the null hypothesis. In this second set of box plots, everything is exactly the same, other than the sample size is now 5,000 instead of 10. The sample means are all exactly the same as what they were above. But when we carry out the test, the p-values here are tiny, indicating very, very strong evidence against the null hypothesis. That much, much larger sample size has found those differences to be highly statistically significant. But whether these differences from the hypothesized value have any practical meaning whatsoever is an entirely different question. If we were to look at this sample mean of 10.1 for a moment, maybe that difference of 0.1 from the hypothesized value will result in a more effective drug or a better marketing campaign. Or maybe, in the context of the problem, a difference of 0.1 is completely and utterly meaningless. The tiny p-value simply tells us that it was very unlikely to observe a difference of this size if the null hypothesis is actually true. In statistics, we determine if there is statistical significance and let experts in the field of interest determine whether the results have any practical importance. In addition to the results of a hypothesis test, it is best to also report an appropriate confidence interval. The confidence interval illustrates the size of the effect and can help to determine if the effect has any practical importance.